Order. Order in the court today.
Hola, mi gente. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome. I just had to hop on the gram, as the kids on TikTok say, to make a quick video. Goya, coming under fire. If you told me at the beginning of this pandemic that Goya would come under fire from cancel culture, I would react with, I would tell you that's not even a funny joke because it doesn't sound even the least bit believable. It's time to put the conspiracy hat back on Mono, because I have a conspiracy take on this. Roll the footage.
That's why I actually don't believe in white privilege, because have you ever had the privilege of going to a white friend's house for dinner? Being the chicken, and I'm like, what was the secret ingredient? Water? Y'all are gonna appropriate anything. Salt. Some people are back out laughing at that. Some people in here like the blow hot dogs.
Now, the timelines match up of when I put that video out versus when people started going after our seasonings. Y'all woke people need to get woker. It is no conspiracy that the Latin community has been running the food game since the dawn of man. Don't at me. Dear white people, as you woke people like to say, stay the fuck away from my habichuelas. What's next? Sofrito's offensive to green people? And the reason why the story of Goya is so powerful is it reflects a lot of what my own family heritage is. My abuelito, he left Puerto Rico and he moved to New York on his own just to work the sugarcane fields, just to make enough money to send back for my abuelita and my dad and his brothers and sisters to bring them to New York, the land of opportunity, to start a life in America. And through hard work and grit, he brought my dad's family over and they started a life that Puerto Ricans are everywhere now. 16 brothers and sisters. I'd like to believe we're at least 6% responsible for all the Puerto Ricans in the country. Now here's where the Goya CEO lost me. So he compared his own grandfather, who immigrated from Spain, came over here and started Goya, to Donald Trump. He said he was a builder. Okay. Well, only one of those builders is a glorified trust fund baby who got a small loan from their father to start their business as a builder. And I'm sorry, this is an attack on flavor. And to the people who are so into this cancel culture and slacktivism of posting stories and being like, yeah, that was good enough, you need to do a little bit of research on these individuals who you're trying to cancel. You should judge people based on the content of their character. Whether you like this current CEO or not, Goya has been a prominent figure in the Hispanic community, employing so many Hispanics across America, headquarters in Puerto Rico, where unemployment is at an all-time high. They just got ripped through with a hurricane, and you're not even thinking. You're just thinking about today, of who can we cancel now? You're done. Your company's over. Okay, what about all the individuals who need that job? And the idea that people are throwing their food in the garbage during a pandemic when we're going into a food shortage. Listen, if you guys want to throw out all your Goya and adobo and sazon and habichuelas, send them to me. I'll take them. I don't give a shit. Shame on you wanting to cancel Goya and all the good work they've done for the Hispanic community and all the bellies they've filled. All because someone has a different political view than you do. Guess what? There's a lot of people who have different political views than you that you work with. And everybody just wants to keep talking about ICE and immigration and ICE, baby. You guys know that was going on before this current administration, right? You don't think they had them in detainment facilities? Read a book, not just Instagram posts. It's like some of you guys just discovered the internet and just realized you can post unlimited stories. You guys know that all these iPhones that you guys been doing all this activism on are made in sweatshops, right? You guys know that these buildings in China where the iPhones are made, they have nets around them because too many people jump off trying to commit suicide and they don't want them to do it on company time. Listen, I'm all for making a difference and trying to build a better tomorrow. You gotta make sure that you're not throwing stones from a glass house. I think the only people that could actually criticize our culture would be like the Amish. And I hear they do some weird shit too. I'll let you guys insult a lot about me. I'll let you even talk shit about my dog. Tell me I should eat boneless wings. But don't you ever come after my Puerto Rican food again. Because at the end of the day, I'm half Puerto Rican. And if I lose any more of that, I think I'm just gonna be a third. So now if I eat Goya, I'm racist? Well, guess what? Racism is delicious. And here's the thing, he didn't even say anything that bad. He said Trump was a builder, and he didn't even clarify a builder of what. He just meant a builder. He could have followed up with, he's a builder of a wall that divides this country. Bet you wouldn't like that. But no, you guys jumped on him for it. And there's all these companies that are just chanting Black Lives Matter, equality, the future is female, down with boneless wings, when they don't really believe it. They're just doing it to pander and virtue signal to the current state of our culture. And listen, I don't think it's right that you should have a say in telling me to cancel Goya. A lot of you motherfuckers didn't even know what Goya was till yesterday. You over here telling me to stop eating this shit, bitch. I used to drink this shit in a baby bottle. My dad used to give me sofrito and malta when I was 6 months old, okay? You're never gonna get me to stop, it's my blood. In the great words of womankind, my body, my choice. Don't tell me what I can put inside of it. Now, if it came out that this CEO was a terrible person, he was ripping off his employees and all of that, yeah, I would reconsider. But he's not doing that. He's employing so many in the Hispanic community, giving them benefits, giving them legit jobs, not just using them under the table like a lot of these companies, making it so they can never get tax returns, making it so they can never get healthcare, making it so they can never have home ownership, building credits, and actually getting a leg up in our society. And if you still think Goya should be canceled, then I personally invite you over for dinner and I will make you some arroz con habichuelas and I will change your mind through food. Buen provecho.